The Sonnet M.2 4x4 PCI Express card was in the past the fastest storage solution for Apple Mac Pro available. Now guess what? Sonnet released brand new version of this amazing monster card with same name, just added the silent word to it. Because this time it's completely passive with no fan. Using this card you can now add up to insane 32 terabytes of super fast NVMe storage to your Apple Mac Pro, Windows or Linux computer. So, let's give it a test. Hi, I'm Teresa from Morgonaut.cloud and I provide personal individual support with Apple Mac, Windows, Linux and server builds. So if you would need any help, just join my website membership, link is in this video description, and I will personally help you while Skype video call and remote session directly to your computer in front of your eyes. Make sure you click the subscribe button below and hit the bell next to it and choose all notifications so you won't miss any of my future videos. This is not any sponsored video. Sonnet did not send me this card for free or to make a review. I bought several of these cards myself, for myself, by my own money. It's a great card, so I felt the need to share my experience and recommendation with you. In higher-end PC world, you can get cards like this. This came to me as a part of expensive MSI Creator TRX 40 motherboard. You can get almost similar cards on Amazon for as low as $60. But there is a big catch. These cheap cards require so-called PCI slot bifurcation, which is part of higher-end PC's motherboard's BIOSes and obviously not present on any Apple Mac. It enables to split the x16 PCI Express slot into four independent x4 PCI Express pieces, so each one of the NVMe disks can be accessed separately. So, for Mac Pro or lower-end PCs, you cannot use these cheap cards at all. So, that's why here comes into place cards like the OWC Excelsior and this Sonnet M.2 4x4 PCI Express card. These cards have built-in onboard PCI Express switch. That means you don't need to rely on the special bifurcation option on some motherboards and you can simply connect it to really any motherboards with PCI Express x16 slot. So it's compatible with Cheesegrater Mac Pro, 2019 Mac Pro, any Windows or Linux computer. I use these cards in my high-end performance FreeBSD file servers. That's insane. But today, I will, for you, install this card into my 2019 Apple Mac Pro. But first, let's unbox it and install four NVMe disks onto this card. If you have single-sided NVMe or double-sided, here you have hint what exact thermal pad thickness you should use and where, so be careful and read it first. Apply appropriate thermal pads to the front and back position. Actual NVMe disks are held by these four tiny screws.
Hey, And I know that it's alarming, yeah. Cause time is running out, and we can't just stay and watch it, no. Oh, we dream about all things being alright, but we freeze when it's all up to us.
The last step is just to attach the big heatsink held by 5 screws. Here we have the final setup. NVMEs are cooled down from both sides. Actual temperatures under load I will show you in a moment. Now let's create a stripe rate 0 array in disk utility. All 4 NVMe disks are recognized out of the box. Select new disks. Be careful not to select any other disk so you don't lose data. As format, I chose APFS. More about it later. Chunk size is very important. Based on data you will store, small or big, choose appropriate chunk size. And here we go, our 8 TB striped array is created. Each disk in System Profiler has its own NVMe controller. The Sonnet card I placed in the x16 slot for the best performance. And let's do a quick test in Blackmagic speed test app. Write speed looks fine, but what the hell is wrong with the read speed? That's not what I want or expect. Maybe bad disks? No, I tested those first. PCI Express placement? Also no, I placed the Sonnet card in the PCI Express x16 slot. So, let me think. Maybe those NVMe disks are throttling down due to high temperatures. Can that be the problem? Let's see. No, temperatures 35 degrees of Celsius are absolutely amazing, so that's not the problem. So let's destroy the array and start from scratch with different settings. I've done a lot of tests with a lot of settings and find out this is the best one for my use case. macOS extended chernlet and chunk size 256K. And as you can see, results are much better now, and most important is absolutely consistent. So I recommend test yourself what exact settings will work the best for your specific workflow. Temperatures are still around 35 degrees of Celsius. That's maybe too cold for NVMEs. And quick test in Blackmagic speed test confirmed my correct settings. This is the performance which must satisfy any high-end video production. Oh my lord! That's simply insanely fast card! There's not much people who could utilize its full potential, but studios with really massive 6 or 8K multicam productions will finally be able to fully utilize their high-end CPUs and GPUs, because the system bottleneck will no more be on the disk side. Hundreds of CPU cores, dozens of high-end GPUs, terabytes of memory, all that will not help you to get better performance if you will have bottleneck on disk setup. That's why you need this card. I installed on it 4 2 TB NVMe drives, Corsair MP600s, not just because they are of course very fast, but mainly because they have massive value of 3600 TBW, terabytes written. That means you can override each of these four disks 1800 times, and that's ideal for any high-end video production where you have to deal with really huge amount of data. So, can I recommend this Sonnet M.2 4x4 PCI Express card? Absolutely, of course! If you want to fully maximize your video or audio editing performance, this card is necessary for any high-end production. Link where you can buy it, you can find right now in this video description. So, I hope I made your day again a little better. If so, please click on the like button below. Click also the share button and share this video with your friends, so it can help to more people. Morgonaut is always here to help. And of course, don't forget to watch my other videos. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my friends.